Good day. I'm talking to Kevin Rogers, who's a recent graduate of the General Management Program here at Gibbs. And Kevin, thank you very much for your time. Would you just start by telling us what your understanding is of the role of a general manager, as opposed to somebody who heads up a function? How is general management different?
Okay, well, I think the challenge with a general manager is really to try and become this conductor of an orchestra. And I think you come from the sort of specialized positions, whether you start out in a specialized position and then just evolve towards a general management. But I think the real challenge of a general manager is to stop being a specialist and to really try and connect the dots. And I think that's the role of any successful general manager is to maybe have come from a specialist financial role or a specialist manufacturing role, and then to step back and trust your specialist below you, but really to be able to try and pull together all the facets and to understand that there's consequences. I mean, to think consequentially, to work out that if you do something on the financial side, it's going to impact on manufacturing. If you do something on manufacturing, it's going to impact on demand planning. So, you know, the real understanding of general management is really to take this so-called helicopter view and really try and put all those pieces together, which is, I suppose it's a challenge in itself.
It's that broader view, an overview of the whole business, an understanding of the different elements, specializing perhaps in one area, but you're now moving into a general management role. You've got to handle the whole business. This program is for people transitioning into that position, or perhaps they fairly newly appointed in a general management position. Would you talk a bit about the structure of the program and how that worked for you as a busy executive?
So I think the starting point where you really spend the first block really starting to understand self was really important. It's a good platform upon which to build the rest of the program, because, you know, regardless of whether you are an experienced general manager, and I came in as a reasonably experienced general manager and really just wanted to almost step back and just try and refine those skills. But one of my colleagues came in as a financial director, coming in and saying he would like to try and understand a little bit more about general management. So the way the course is structured, it's got a good balance between really intensive block program, as I said, to the insights side of it, where you really get to understand self and understand what drives you as a leader, what drives your team, was a really, really good starting point. The simulations in between the programs worked really, really well for us. It kept momentum. And then the various blocks were well spaced enough to almost take the learnings from the block and to try and go and practice them. Yeah. I mean, sometimes we're successful in them. Yeah. And other times not as successful, but it gave you that ability not to take all this theory and absorb sort of 10-15% of it and then forget the rest of it. Whereas it was enough of an intense sort of session to be able to absorb that, go out and practice it, and almost inculcate that culture of, okay, let me go and try and see if this works with my team, which is, I mean, it was absolutely invaluable. Yeah. The teamwork, the simulation sessions, the teamwork, the competition between the teams was fantastic. It's a really, really well-balanced program.
A real feature of this program is the amount of coaching.
Yes.
Coaching in teams, coaching individually, triads. Could you talk a bit about the coaching element?
Yeah, look, the coaching is an incredibly strong part of the course. And I know from within our team, there's two or three of us who have used Keith. Subsequent to the course, just you having a struggle and you call upon your coach. For me, it was the first time I'd ever worked with a coach. So you sort of go into it not really unknowing what is this about. But again, the balance of individual coaching versus team coaching, the honesty that came out of those sessions, the honesty of your coach, but also the honesty of your teammates in them giving you honest feedback as to your interaction with the team. You know, and coming off the start where we started with that insights side of the course, which you really started to understand whether you're a fiery red or a cool blue, but you started to come into it saying, okay, I understand a little bit more about myself. That being built on with the coach, absolutely, absolutely invaluable. So I think the coaching and talking to the other classmates, I mean, coaching was one of the things that everybody said that was highly valuable. So, yeah, no, it's very good.
Yeah. So this blended approach of CEO inputs, so-called academic inputs, the simulation running through the program, the intensive coaching before and even after the program, made for a well-balanced program. It was unusual in some ways as well. Towards the end of the program, we finished with an immersion in downtown Joburg. Would you like to chat about that briefly?
That was fascinating. I mean, because, you know, we'd spoken quite a bit about strategy. We'd spoken quite a bit about the need to be a general manager and the need to almost remove yourself sometimes from the hubbub of what's happening at grassroots level, but to equally be able to rise up, have a look at what's going on, and then immerse yourself back down into the markets, and to stop making assumptions, to really to take a deep dive sometimes into your market, understand what's going on. And I mean, the trip down into downtown Johannesburg was an immersion that, I mean, I think we've carried it through in our business now, but when we went up in the Colton Tower, it sort of gave you this helicopter view of Joburg, and there wasn't really much noise. You could see what was going on, but the moment you dropped down into street level, it was a very good analogy between what a general manager needs to do, how he needs to go up to the 50th floor, have a look at what's going on, really see a completely different picture. But when you came down to ground zero and you walked out into the street, all of a sudden everything you'd seen at the 50th floor was completely different to what you were seeing at grassroots level. And then, I mean, just to see what was going on in our market in Johannesburg, you know, you sit in your, I would say your ivory tower, but you sit in your office, and it's got no relevance to what's actually happening in the market. So it really taught you two things. It taught you about the need to rise up and have a look at what's going on and then immerse yourself. And also if you're going to get into a market, really go and do the research and go and understand the market so that when you come back into your business, you can start being that conductor and saying, look, this is what's happening in the market. This is what I've seen, challenge the assumptions. It was a fitting end to the course, and obviously to finish at the Constitutional Court was just a highlight. It was just specifically South African, but it was fantastic.
Yeah. Perhaps a last question around the content being delivered by Gibbs and the experiences, but you touched on it earlier, the networking and what you learned from your colleagues, your delegates, your classmates. Could you?
Look, that again, it's invaluable because there were four of us in our syndication group, but I mean, we also worked in cross-functional teams, and we had a very, it was a small class, but it was a very close class. We had somebody coming out of a parastatal, so out of PRASA. We had somebody who had come out of the construction industry and their business was growing at a rapid rate. That was presenting its challenges. We had somebody who came out of the advertising industry, and to really just take those diverse cross-functional business experiences, and what it proved was your thinking is not necessarily always the right thinking. Somebody from the construction industry will come with a completely different take on a problem, on a solution to the problem, and that for me was highly valuable. Just and as a team, we swapped roles in the syndication quite frequently. So for one quarter you'd be the HR exec, the next quarter you'd be the manufacturing exec, and we watched how each individual struggled sometimes with the demands of their new role in the syndication. But it's at the end, you know, people were going, I didn't think I could ever run a manufacturing plant, but I've gained that experience. So that was really valuable. And I think the second part was the part of the Gibbs program that's really, really beneficial is seeing industry leaders, where you had certain industry leaders come through from South African breweries and from the metals industry and just come and experience or tell us about their experiences. And, you know, so, and it was in context with the learnings from the day were then reiterated by somebody who had been the top of their industry. So that was, it was in a relaxed environment where you could really ask questions, and you know, some of them were people that you'd really look up to. But they were, I mean, that was a really good part of the Gibbs course as well.
Sure. Well, it's been great talking to you, Kevin. Thanks very much indeed for coming and chatting about the General Management Program. Thank you.
Pleasure, Cole.